Hey everybody and welcome back to Wide Open Water. Today I am going to do some winter camping on St. Croix. I'm going to go after some sturgeon while I'm out there, but I got the sled all packed up there. It's quite a bit of gear. You need a heater, basically something to sleep on. It ends up being a lot of gear, so I better start moving. Might have to do a second trip here, come back with the cot and all the camping gear later, but it's going to be a fun night, so let's get to it. So I'm officially set up here in the shack. I have one rod for jigging, one rod that's set for a set line. Both of them are for sturgeon. I got the live scope rolling. Everything else is set up. These foam mats are really nice. I'm currently just in my socks on top of the ice, but I got my little table there that's gonna be a kitchen later for cooking up some soup. I got all my camera gear on my cot. I got the propane heater right there, got the boots all nicely organized, but I got the propane outside, and then also on top of my table over here, that white guy there is a carbon monoxide detector. That's pretty important. So for Christmas, my sister and my brother-in-law got me this nice little cooking set, so I'm going to test it out today. It comes with some reusable silverware, and there's a teapot, there's a pot for boiling water, and a just regular like sauteing pan in there. So I think I'm gonna make up some soup right now. So we're gonna have some extra noodle tonight. Pretty simple, all you need is water, and you just dump in the packet once it's boiling. So we got dinner ready tonight. The soup looks amazing. It's gonna taste great. So far the fishing has been very slow. I got some fresh bait on both of them, some minnows and some night crawlers. But until we get our first fish, I'm gonna keep eating the soup. So cheers. So it's about 11 o'clock right now and no bites yet. So hopeful, but right now I have been watching some YouTube, kind of getting caught up in all the fishing videos that I like. Right now, I'm just gonna get comfy, lay in the cot, watch my two lines that I got in the water, and let's just see what happens. Other than that, if I get hungry, I have a couple more snacks. Maybe I'll bust out the fruit snacks in a little bit, but I'm very happy with this setup. This Otter Resort is huge. I've been running this Big Buddy heater on medium the whole time, connected to a 20-pound tank. I'm sure that'll be plenty of propane for the night. But I also have a very cheap option. Well, at least cheapish. Right now I have my Dakota Lithium power pack there, but this light connects to goes through a USB cord. So if you have a power pack, you can power this little light bulb up there. And that's only like $10 on Amazon compared to like the $60, $70, whatever people are buying for lights. But right now I think that's like the cheapest option for running a light. I did have the Otter Resort lights before, or not resort, but the Otter lights that have a dimmer switch. I'm going to miss the dimmer switch, but the other ones were not working anymore, and for only $10, this has been pretty incredible. So let's go back to the YouTube watching, and I hope the next clip you guys watch is a fish, but we'll see. So I was kind of laying down watching some Netflix, and I saw my bobber kind of jumping around, and we finally did it tonight. I think it's midnight right now. I was in my sleeping bag and my sweatshirt and shorts, but we got a sturgeon. I'm gonna unhook it and I'll show you here. So it's just a little guy. But the goal of the night was just to catch one. It's the first time out this year. He's probably 28, maybe 30 inches. But I'm just so happy just to catch one. We're going to like put him back here.
First sturgeon of the night. Just going to hold him here. There he goes.
So we just got that fish put back in the water. It's about midnight right now. I've been out here since about 2 p.m. So what's that now? 10 hours, one fish. Sturgeon fishing, I've been told, is not a numbers game. And you're lucky if you get out here and you catch one. My goal, the trip, it's not the first time I've been on the river. And actually the second time I've been fishing ever since there's been ice this year. That was actually my first fish of 2021, so that's pretty cool. It's a very unique fish to catch. I was getting very tired a little bit ago, but now I have a burst of energy. So just going to keep watching the bobbers, and next time you guys see me, I'm going to hopefully be able to film the catch of the fish. Sorry about that before. I was watching some Netflix, kind of watching a show here in my bed. Kind of keeping an eye on the bobbers just because it was really slow. And sure enough, when I'm not ready, or whenever I don't have any fish or any camera set up to film anything, I get a fish. I didn't want to film anything fake for that. I just basically, since I got the fish up, show it off, let it go. I don't want to stress them out any more than I'm doing already. At this point, I'm going to stop talking and get back to fishing. So let's do it. All right, we have fish number two on right now. This thing is definitely bigger than the last one that I had on. This thing took off. I saw the bite. Bobber is kind of bouncing around. I'm betting this is 40 inches maybe. We'll see what happens. We got fish number two tonight. This one's definitely bigger than 30 inches. Pretty fat. I'm not sure how big he is. He's got a big lamprey mark on his head. I'm gonna get a quick measurement on him. So we got roughly from the tip of the nose all the way down. He is, I'm gonna say he's just shy of 40. Still a solid fish, number two of the night. Yeah, pretty incredible. I don't want to have him out too long, so we're going to let this guy just go right back down into the St. Croix. I'm going to hold him here, though, until he's ready. Fish number two, 39, just about 40. So we just got that fish put back, 39 and 3/4, we'll say. I might be on a feeding window because that fish just bit about 30 minutes after that other fish. I'm gonna rebait everything and get resituated. So I wanted to do a little update camping last night. The propane outside got so cold that it froze and I wasn't able to continuously have heat. So about 3:30, 4 a.m. I had no more heat in the tent. Very lucky that I had a 0-degree sleeping bag. So basically I just got all bundled up and jumped in that for the rest of the night. Wasn't too bad actually. I think it only dropped down to about 12 degrees. Pretty chilly still, not ideal. Now that I just woke up, my propane is working again. So hopefully that keeps going for me. After that, breakfast today is going to be pretty simple. I got like a little peanut butter biscuit bar, which are pretty good. I got a couple fruit snacks. Probably not the healthiest breakfast, but it's simple since I'm kind of ran out here in a hurry just to do this little camping trip. But I think right now I'm going to check my lines. Both of them seem to be good still, but I'm going to put some fresh bait on and see if we can get another fish.
Kind of a funny side note.
having no heat last night, all my holes froze over last night. So it did get a little chilly in here. Well, it's currently 3 o'clock and I'm gonna start packing up here. I'm gonna leave the lines in while I'm getting all the gear situated. It's gonna take me a while probably to get everything back to the truck. I wanted to do it before it gets dark. It's 3:10 right now. I think I have about an hour and a half till sunset. It's been a lot of fun out here. This whole weekend is a really long one with New Year's. Got to do some fun things in New Year's. Then I got to cap off the weekend coming out here and fishing. And we ended up catching 2 fish, so that was pretty incredible. I think I'm going to do more of these ice fishing videos. If there's a certain fish that you guys want me to try targeting through the ice while I'm camping, just comment down below and I'll try to get to it. If there's something that you guys want me to show more with my setup, I probably didn't do a very good job showing that off. I'd be more than happy to show or feature something more in the future. But until next time, guys, I'm Camden Droppo with Wide Open Water, and I'll catch you later.